Today, we're going to be making the top part of the space shuttle actually launch off. Let's go ahead and get this thing started. I do not know what's going on with that over there. Okay, we just got to ignore that. All right, so if you didn't know what I mean by that, in real life, these top parts can actually basically eject themselves off if an emergency happens or just when they're in outer space because they don't need all this extra weight on the back. Okay, I think that's how they land on the moon. Anyways, let's go ahead and do that. So right here is our entire top area that we want to basically fly off of this thing. This will be actually very interesting to do. So the first thing we need to do is make like some type of support beam in the actual bottom of this thing somewhere down here. So we're just gonna make like a big line right here, and then we're gonna grab a what's it called, hard point connector, and this will actually be the one thing that's carrying this entire like spaceship. So if this thing breaks, we're probably gonna have some issues. And then of course, to actually connect it to that, we're gonna go ahead and add this hard point connector, and there we go. See, that's all we need. And then now we actually need to make this an entirely different body, so we need to find like the perfect area for that. I think it's right there, and most importantly, it has to be watertight or we will have issues, or space tight basically is what I mean. So we're gonna bring this up, and that does not look watertight, so it looks like we need to actually copy the flooring with it, so that shouldn't be an issue at all. Wait, is it an issue? Hold on, how, wait, what's going on here? Oh no, I forgot we did this. It looks a little bit different than how we did it, I thought. But what we're gonna do just for this, we're gonna make this 1x2 wedge right here and just do that. Hopefully that still means we can climb up here, but I don't think it matters too much. We'll see, of course. So what we're gonna do is copy everything up here. Oop, I think we did it one block too much, so we're gonna cut it off by one block, and there we go. So all this stuff right here will be launched off the top of this thing, and it should be pretty smooth. We're gonna go ahead and cut it off, deselect the selection grid, and make sure we didn't miss anything. I think we've gotten everything important, so we're gonna go ahead and repaste this back here, go to our merge tool, and see what's going on down here. So actually, that's on the same body. Since it's red, we have to connect it to that one. It's already merged in, so let's spawn this in, and it should be connected already, and it is. I feel like there's something might be wrong with the default rocket. Anyways, we have disconnected our space shuttle, and I can actually kind of see where it disconnects at, which is kind of cringe a little bit, but you know what, that should be fine. If we go in here, yeah, so obviously, hold on, we're gonna do infinite electric here. None of our buttons will work, I don't think. So main engines, yeah, wait, oh, those worked. Oh yeah, because they're connected to our body. So now we need to actually have a button that launches this top part off so we can have separate controls on it from this. So what we're gonna do is grab a key button, and this key button will actually be, let's see, it'll unlock the main button here. So we're gonna put the key button right here, and then it'll have this lockable button, and this lockable button is like the safe for it, so we don't accidentally press it, which that would suck. We're gonna have it open, let's see, I want to open it sideways here. I can't get it sideways, there we go. So it should open sideways. We have to unlock it by clicking that, there we go. And we just ended up naming it unlock stage, and then we named this one stage, so it's quite interesting. And then stage will be connected to, let's see, so toggled will disconnect that right there, and I don't think that would actually work because it's a separate body. This is when stuff does start to cause problems here, because now we need to figure out a way to somehow transfer information from here to over here. Oh, don't do that. Since it's like a separate object, we can't transfer any type of information, but we can launch our SRBs, which is quite interesting. So we can go ahead and do SRB launch right here, and SRBs do work, which is quite interesting, and it's ooh, it doesn't look that good when they're out launch, but those only work because they're actually connected to our main body, which is quite interesting looking. But yeah, main engines don't work like at all. Let's go ahead and do unlock stage here and see if it does anything. Yeah, it doesn't even work because we have to do some like composite here. Well, actually, it looks like we only need a microcontroller for our throttle right here, and same with the engine starter, which makes this actually very easy. What does that activate? Is that our parachutes? I think it might be. Yeah, it is. Oh, wait, no, that's our monitor. Anyways, we need to go ahead and make that microcroller. So I'm gonna kind of show you guys how to do that if you're trying to like communicate with a different subgrid. Okay, so we got our microcontroller here. We're just gonna name this space rocket micro. Yeah, that'll work. And then we have to go to the logic menu here. We're gonna do add this, so we will have a number input, and then we will go to, oh wait, I kind of forgot how to do this. Let's see, we need a number input either way, and then an on and off input to actually start the engine. So we're gonna do rocket on for this. I spelled rocket on, so rocket on, and then number will be the throttle for the rocket, so we'll just do something like that. All right, I spelled throttle a little bit interesting here, but then we want a composite one, and I think it's a composite output. This would go to the hard point connector, we'll just say. So we'll run it all through this one right here. Let's see, anything else we need to do for over here? I don't think so. So now we need to basically just connect these to each other. You're always going to want them facing each other when you first start, because that's just how they basically run here. All right, so throttle, we'll go ahead and grab, we're not going to type in throttle, I think it's like number. So if we just type in number here, there should be something here that'll like transfer it into a composite. So is it this one right here? I think it is. So input one will go to there, and then that will go to there. I think that's how you do it. And we have the on and off one. So if we go to on for, wait, no, if we just search up composite, it'll give us all of them. So we're just gonna do that. Composite read on and off. I think, nope, we want the opposite of that. So composite write on and off. That is exactly what we need. We're going to connect that up to that. Let's see. I think I did it right, but we're going to go ahead and test it out. So we're going to save this. And now we have our super advanced space microcontroller right here that we'll slam down. We'll go to composite. It'll output to, wait, we can't send it through this. I'm so confused. You know, we might have to actually flip this around for this to work. I did put it the wrong way, I've just realized. So what we're going to do is just rotate it a little bit here. So if we do that, click L two times, because that's exactly how you rotate something. Paste it back in how it was, merge it into that one, and then this one will go to actually that one now. So now we've just swapped it around. It's pretty simple, but it should do the same thing. But we only did that because our composite thing wasn't connected. So now if we drag this to composite data send, so we're sending data to everything down here. Yep, that's exactly how we wanted it. We did have it wrong. Then we have our other ones we did over here. So the throttle for the actual rocket itself is that one right there. To actually start it is rocket on. Which one's rocket on? Engines are right there. Now we need to make the other microcontroller. So now we need a microcontroller room for somewhere down here, and that's in like a relatively safe spot. So probably not near the bottom, because we may have some rough landing. So we'll just do somewhere in the middle, probably like in between maybe one of these things. I think there's a little bit of room. Yeah, we'll do that. All right, to actually descript it, we're gonna go to a composite, and this will actually be a composite input from the one we're receiving. We'll do an on and off output. That'll be the engines, and then we need a throttle one, which will be a number, because the throttle is always a number output. This will be the throttle for our engine. So pretty simple stuff we're doing here. Or I think it's simple, at least. I don't know. I barely even understand it myself. I just kind of know how to do it. And as you can see, it's kind of opposite this time. And now we need a composite read on slash off. So this is very simple. You just line it up. It's on the one. Now we need a composite write number. I think it's a read number we need. So yep, exactly. Yep. So very simple this time. Hopefully these two don't interfere since they're on the same channel. But if it does, we'll just switch number to two. Anyways, I think we're good with this one. We're going to go over that microcontroller there. And let's go ahead and do this right there. And then the composite that's receiving it will go to data receive. And we're going to go to our logic menu, go to engines, and these will start these engines right here. Awesome. Oh, that's our SRBs. Oop, wrong one. That did look like our engines there. So engines will go straight to ignition. There we go. We got it right that time. And there's another one for throttle, and that goes to throttle. Perfect. All right. So this should now technically work. Of course, we're going to go ahead and test it out. Oh, I really hate that thing next to my rocket. It might just like at some point accidentally run into it and destroy everything. Let's see. Can we actually activate main engines here? And main engines on, throttle up, and we can. So this system does work. You can use it in your own builds here. We're going to throttle up, and yep, everything basically works. Did they make rockets slower? Because I swear I was going much faster than that. Is there something wrong? Did they do an update or something? I feel like they might have. Hold on, I need to turn down my game. What the heck? We used to go up way faster than this. I think they've definitely done some fine tuning to their game here. We're going to go ahead and do only SRB. So SRB's launch. Here we go. I still feel like we would have gone up faster, but this is quite interesting here. So I don't know if this eject thing that really works. So we're going to do unlock stage and then release. So, oh my gosh, this looks really weird. Okay, release SRBs. There we go. You're going to want to keep those released. We have something sticking out of this. I could probably fix that by just putting it into our floorboard right there. But yeah, we have this little capsule here that we will be able to control with some space thrusters that I do know about. With those, you actually need air tanks. So it's going to be interesting how we do that. But just to adds like some more design to this thing, I want it to actually launch off the top so we get like some room and we don't run into the rocket itself. So for this thing to actually launch off the top of this thing, basically like an ejection seat, we're gonna go ahead and make some like fuel lines or something. Delete these blocks right here because we don't need them. Oh yeah, and first of all, we need to rise this block into the floorboard here. So hopefully there's nothing in the way. We're gonna see real quick, is there anything I'd be getting in the way of? Ooh, I think, oh yeah, nope, I think we just barely cleared it. Okay, I was worried about that staircase, but nope, we're good. We're gonna merge that in there, and then we actually need to go ahead and copy this bottom part here, because we can't just delete it and replace it. We could, but that'd be a lot of work because we'd have to reconnect like all the logic and stuff. Yeah, we're good. All right, so right here's where our disconnect sets. Now we need some rockets to actually launch us off of this thing and get a decent ways from it. So we're gonna use some small ones. What are the medium ones? Are the medium ones pretty big for this? So these are the medium ones. Oh, we do not need a medium one. Okay, that's like how we actually take off. We're gonna do a, what's it called, small one. We'll be good with that. All right, so I've just checked, we don't really have a whole lot of room for this. We're gonna turn on symmetry and see what this basically does for us. So what we can do is put some rocket fuel things on that right there, and maybe we can do like just two of them. Ooh, I feel like those really look weird though, like right there. Maybe we could actually block it off in the inside here so we can't see them. So what we're gonna do is actually make them in the inside so we can't like visually see them on the out. So we're gonna do right there and right there just to completely block it off and basically airlock it. We'll grab a throttle or a rocket booster right here and just connect it to it like that. We could actually probably add another one. We need the rocket booster itself. We have to retype in rocket and grab the small one. And there we go. Basically, just like that, we have rockets. But now we got to do it to the other side. I'll do the off screen so you don't have to bore watching it. All right, so we're probably going to keep a burn rate on 100% just because we don't want the rockets to actually be running for too long here. The disconnect button is that one right there. Disconnect will also be connected to the activation of the launches on the rocket. So now this thing should basically launch off the side. It should go straight vertical, which might be an issue. But let's go ahead and, of course, test it out. So we're going to go in here, and then I think it's unlocked stage right here. It'll launch ourselves off. Oop, okay, so it does launch ourselves off. I think we've added too much fuel. I feel like that might be too much, but we don't want these SRBs on us also when we do that. So we want to keep those. We want to disconnect those the second we launch, just in case they're still attached for some reason. So we're going to go to our logic thing here, and we're going to go ahead and get a ore. I think that's the right one, and this ore will basically do something here. So A should be connected, or these launch ones will just be connected to launching both of those. And what is that actually already connected to? Okay, it's connected to this. So SRB release will be connected to A on here, and then the B one will be connected to what's it called, the eject, just in case they're still on, so to launch them off stage one. Yep, we'll do that, and I think we're good now. So now they should technically launch off if one of those are active. So we're gonna go ahead and do unlock stage, launch this thing off, and yep, so it releases the SRBs too. Yeah, we don't need this much fuel. I think we've added too much. I think we'd be fine with just one fuel pod thing. But then we're offline here. I can click space to activate a parachute, and we basically have these rocket boosters as landing pads. So it's really cool how this actually all worked out and went to plan, basically. And then we have our door right there. Oh, this is perfect. The main issue would be if we did land on the moon with this. It isn't like a moon lander. This is basically just an ejection seat, but there'd be no way to get back. So this is definitely not for, like, you know, going to the moon. It's only to eject if there is an emergency, but we did safely land, and then we can just calmly get out of the vehicle just like that. Wow, so that did really all go to plan there. But now we're gonna test if we do the release SRBs, if this one works. Okay, you probably don't know what I mean, but we're gonna do SRB launch. Ooh, what's going on here? SRB launch isn't working. Why aren't we throttling up? Maybe if we release them. Wait, why wasn't that working? That's actually really weird. Maybe the vehicle's like glitched into the ground. So wait, they're actually already risen off the ground. This shouldn't be an issue, guys. What's going on here? Those are SRBs flying. We're gonna go in this thing, try it out again. Maybe it's just like a weird glitch. SRB launch. What the heck? Why aren't the SRBs working? Is it because there's like two different subgrids? That's really weird. Maybe if we do activate main engines, that'll kind of help it start up here. Main engines on. Wait, we're like stuck into the floor. Is that what's going on? Are we glitched? I think we are. Well, that's really weird. Our rocket's doing basically everything it can right now to try taking off. SRBs have been launched. Ooh, stuff is starting to happen. Okay, we're gonna go ahead and release SRBs. Maybe the SRBs are just slowing us down here, so release those. That's not the issue. What the heck? Okay, we might have to change launching sites here. Yeah, wait, so guys, look, there's actually a block underground. Okay, we've just switched actual space rocket launch sites. So this is one they did add into the game. We're gonna go ahead and spawn it here. It's cool how it already... Okay, so are we glitched again? Nope. Okay, it's good now. We're gonna go ahead and launch this, see if it works. So SRB launch. So SRBs do propel us now, and then we can release them also. So yep, it all works. I probably should have known that from the last test we just did, but yeah, it should perfectly also go down. We can launch our parachute, and whoa, this does not slow down at all. What was that about? What the heck? Okay, so it looks like this thing's literally not gonna land unless you actually take off the front part here. So if you for some reason need to, you can do unlock stage and get the heck out of this thing. I mean, that is... oh yeah, okay, that's what we're gonna do right now. What we're gonna do now is go ahead and delete the extra fuel thing we had. So we have two fuel things in here. We're gonna go ahead and delete one, delete the other one, because we definitely have way too much fuel for this. I think we only need one booster. So there we go, and now we should have basically no type of stuff like that happen. All right, ultimate test here. We're gonna do unlock stage. This is an emergency ejection, and here we go. Oh, this thing, that's way too much. What's going on? I feel like that lasted even longer than it did last time. Did it like not save or something? Okay, our parachute actually saved us right there. That was really cool. We're gonna test it again, because I don't think it like actually saved that time. So we're gonna go in here, do unlock stage, turn on our monitors just so we can kind of... wait, what happened? Oh no, we have to switch our video feed on the monitors. Oh gosh, this is terrible. I don't know what that rocket's doing over there. It's for some reason like really broken. I see it like leaking air. Okay, anyways, we need to launch this thing. We're gonna do eject right there. It'll eject us for just a little bit. Okay, that was way better. It wasn't too long or too short. starts, and we're gonna perfectly land. This one goes down very slow. Touchdown, here we go. So now what we need to add is these little RCS thrusters that basically help us maneuver in space. If you add enough of them, they actually do work on land, so I guess we could maybe try doing that. But honestly, I have no idea how to use them, and these default ones actually don't really work that well, or like the microcontroller that's on the default rocket that I use right here. So I went ahead and subscribed to Prof Cognito's RCS thruster tutorial thing right here. So this basically shows us exactly what it does. We have an up and down, all this stuff. So I might just go ahead and copy this one right here because I don't know how to use them. There'd be no way else I'd really know how to. We do have some controls here. So what does this mean? Strafe mode. I don't know what strafe mode means. Okay, that's cool. We'll probably just add this to our thing here. So I'm kind of confused. Does it really matter where I put these at? Because it looks like they have like a multiple sides to them. So we're just going to go ahead and copy this. By the way, the RCS thing is right here. RCS thruster tutorial right there. We're going to go to our space rocket here. And where should we put these? Oh, I just realized I forgot the microcontroller with it. We basically have no room. And oh my gosh, I just forgot something. We need actual air canisters to fuel these because these don't just run off of their own. They need actual fuel, basically. So I have no clue where to put these. Maybe like right here. Actually, this wouldn't be a bad spot. I think we have enough room. Maybe it'd hang off the side just a little bit like that. And then it wouldn't actually get in the way of our SRBs launching off if they're still active. So we could put that right there. I don't know if this is at all right. Right there. And then it could line down here and go into like some type of oxygen tube or whatever kind of fuel that needs. So how do I do it on this side? What kind of like rotation do I do? Oh, definitely not O. Maybe I. Nope, not I. Okay, there we go. So I think this is the right way to do it. If it's not, I'll definitely realize it. So we're gonna go ahead and put this right here on this side. And I think we've gotten it basically. We're gonna go do that. Go to our tank. So we got to type in tank now, and we need our small tank. We don't have enough room for basically anything else. That's kind of concerning. So we're gonna go down here, see where we have room for these tanks at. So we're gonna do one like, oh my gosh, it's really cramped in here, but we do have a lot of room. I could say that. Place two on each side. That should be plenty of fuel. We're not gonna use that like too much. So we're just gonna go do that. Grab this pipe right here, and then we need a, what's it called? Whatever this one is. Nope, wrong one. We need one that goes up and turns at the same time. So really complicated pipes we're gonna do here. It can't be just open like this. So we need a, what's it called? Just a straight pipe that basically separates that. Connect a pipe right there, and we've connected it, but we still need to connect the fuel line under here. So we're gonna go do that. Oh gosh, guys, it looks like I forgot an RCS thruster right there. Hopefully that isn't too important. It's probably not. But what kind of fuel do these things take? So if we go ahead and select them, maybe we have to go search up RCS thruster in here. Does it say like what type of fuel it takes? I don't really know. Fluid supply. Okay, it says fluid supply. We're gonna go down here. Does it take fluid supply? Yeah, I don't know what fluid supply means. Is it like hydraulic? Okay, well on his, he just did fuel tank air. It just had air in it, but his is also much larger, but we'll see what we can do here. Something I did forget is the microcontroller. So what do we do with this thing here? We have, oh, instrument panels. Okay, do we need the instrument panel or do we like need a pass on that? I don't think it matters too much here. You know what? Here's what we'll do. We're gonna go to copy the instrument panel. We'll put it somewhere up here. We're gonna copy everything down here, including the seat, because this will be our co-pilot's job, basically, to mess with the RCS thrusters. They'll probably have like their degree or something in it because the pilot's worried about piloting and someone else can be worried about, you know, doing the piloting also. So we're gonna copy this and put it in ours here. Big shout out to Prof Cognito. Link is in the description for his channel. He's the one that kind of helped with that tutorial right there. We're gonna go ahead. Actually, he made the tutorial. We're gonna put our new seats right here. We need to make it like go in a certain way. So we'll do something like this. It'll go like straight vertically in the air. Lovely. Now we got a new seat in this thing with composite connected. Now we need this microcontroller right here to be actually in our little microcontroller room somewhere down here. We are really running out of room. I forgot we have a second story for microcontrollers. I think we'll be fine here, but I might add a couple more microcontrollers, but we'll see. And then we need our instrument panel. This is very important. We're gonna copy that. And where should this be? I think we're just gonna put it right there. We're honestly doing random stuff for our instruments right now until we actually do our systems video on this or whatever we do for it. So in signal, out signal. I think we got it all connected. Besides the important stuff here. All right, so where does this microcontroller, where did it go? Okay, so RCS thrusters goes to where? Oh gosh, it doesn't tell me here. Oh, RCS slash instrument panel. Okay, so that just means we connect it to all of this, and that's all we really should have to do. We're gonna spawn this in and test it out. And the RCS thrusters should go the same way. I've noticed that. So we're gonna go to our co-pilot seat here. Okay, it does work. So that goes left. That's that way. Should we spawn this on the moon and see if these actually work? You know, and honestly, that sounds like a really good idea. Space rocket right here. Where is this at? Oh, we're like in the air right here. What the heck? Okay, that's glitched a little bit. So now if we go on our map here and go to the moon, it should be somewhere over here. Yep, see, this is where our rocket is at right now. We're currently teleporting over there, and we're gonna see if this actually works on the moon. Is my game crashed? What's going on here? All right, there we go. We are back in space here once and for all. We're gonna go ahead and actually, oh, we're tipping over here. I'm feeling it. Why are we tipping over? This thing has really good supports on it. Hold on, maybe if we restart the add-on here, it shouldn't be tipping over. Is it really on an uneven surface? Oh, it is. Oh, this is bad. Okay, we're gonna go up here really fast. Click the eject button. Here we go. Eject, unlock stage, and get out of there. And there we go. Okay, so that works. That's good, at least. Then we have our thrusters here that I can't even control because I'm in the wrong seat. Where am I? Okay, we need to get to the passenger seat. It's right there. And now we have control of these thrusters, which do work. Okay, I don't know if they work in the right direction, but we could probably figure it out. This is down here, and down does try pushing us down. I can kind of feel it, and then up pushes us up. Oh, I definitely feel that. So, guys, I really do think this is actually coming together quite well. I'm kind of having an issue trying to get back to the ground, though. I'm holding down right now and it's not seeming to work, and we're actually going the wrong direction here. That's kind of weird. All right, try angling down like this and then hold the down right here. I don't know how well these really work in space. We're probably going to run out of these air fuel things here in a second because we're really using a lot of this. Actually, we shouldn't. I basically got this thing angled straight down right now with throttle. I can kind of see us starting to go down, but it's going to be a little bit here. Maybe we should add like some type of rockets on this thing that I can control that aren't those rockets. So maybe just like a single-use rocket, but that might be... Oh, I think we're starting to go down here. I can feel it. So I definitely think it does work. We're going to try making a moon landing here. Even though this isn't a moon type of thing here, we can still at least try landing on the moon. We're definitely not going to get back, but I don't think there's a single one that can yet. Here we go. We need to start getting prepared because we're about to smack in. All right, we're going to go do that. We're going to go ahead and probably deploy our parachute. No, don't do that. Oh, that was a really bad... Okay, you know what? I don't know how well this actually does work. You know, probably could use some customizations here, but guys, it does work. We're probably going to go ahead and end this video there. Let me know in the comments what we should actually add next to this thing. There's a whole bunch of stuff we probably could add. We need to add the system still, all the batteries. Oh, it's gonna be a big old process. Look at that, we're about to have a solar eclipse. Anyways, make sure you guys go to like, subscribe, hit that bell, join the Discord, link is in the description. We host events there normally weekly, but thanks for watching and goodbye.